place here, but we know who holds it all in His hand. We're glad to have you with us this morning, Mike Blanton and Evidence. If you haven't heard these folks sing, you're in for a treat this morning. And I told Mike that what we're going to do today is just let them start singing. Let's let God lead. They may sing us all the way to the lunch hour. That's fine. Or even beyond. We don't, you know, we won't leave here real until about 9 o'clock tonight. That's fine with us. But anyway, so if, you know, God puts a shout in your heart, you shout. You want to raise your hand, you raise your hand. You want to stand, you stand. You want to run, you run. Whatever. But just make sure you do it as God is calling you to do so. All right? So we pray that you'll just be blessed today in a special way. So we're going to ask him to come. And as again I said earlier, he is a graduate of Russell High School. How he got up in Columbus, Ohio, Eric, we don't know. But he's up there. So just give him a big amen, would you please?
Amen.
Precious friend, let His will be done. Praise Him.
This whole body of flesh we'll leave here behind us. It will never again fill with pain. For we'll stand in the presence of Jesus our Savior and the glorified one.
Probably help you if you just turn the monitor off. That's what's, or turn the highs down. That's what's causing the feedback, I believe. I think we can hear enough from the mains, and we don't hear good anyhow. So, we sing off key or on key, it don't matter. If the Lord shows up, He fills the building. Amen. We're glad to be at the First Baptist Church. I remember, Brother Tom already told you, I graduated from Russell High School, 1981. I got my license right downtown here. I never will forget it. I pulled out, and the cop must have been having a good day, because I pulled out past the mailman. He was sitting there getting mail out, and flashers flashing. I passed him like it. He said, "You know, you might order to not pass him." I said, he wasn't going nowhere. So we went on, and that's when you had the back end, a parallel park between real cars. Which I think that's a lot better than cones. I can hit something I can see better than I can't see. But he was having a good day that day, evidently, because he gave me my license. And my wife feels like that she's been blessed to get a ride with me all these years. And she wondered who gave me my license. But it's good to be here and good to be in the house of the Lord. Glad you come out on this icy. So we had about 4 inches of snow in Grove City when we left this morning. And my wife said, "We're going to get down there and it's going to cancel. They're going to cancel service." I said, "We'll just take a nap." We're supposed to be in Tollesboro, Kentucky tonight, so we can't stay till 9. But how many would stay here and listen to us till 9?
Amen.
Thank all five of you. Hit the altar. Now, you know that wasn't the truth. He did not tell the truth. Amen. We got a brand new CD just came out. Matter of fact, I just got it Friday. And we've got it with us, and I want to do some songs off that. Would that be okay? And we've already got orders from the preacher's wife, some songs we got to do. And so we just want you to mind the Lord. Now look at your neighbor and say, "You're looking as good as you can." All right, so let's do something off that new part. We've already done two, but let's do something.
Blood of the Lamb. He bought me with the
washed in the blood of the Lamb.
Song, as Mike mentioned, we have a new project that just came out. I love the message in this song. This is probably one of the first ones we found for it. And you know, I don't know about you, but I've learned as I get older. I'll be 40 years old this year, and I got saved when I was 14 years old. And I've learned as I get older in Him, and learn more that I'm dependent more on Him. You know, as we get older and things that happen, and you know, there's this life happens. You know, we go through stuff, and sometimes it's out of our control. Sometimes it's out of our hands. Sometimes it was not our doing. But I'm glad that He's faithful in every situation that comes
Amen.
Along. And I've learned, the old song says, 'tis so sweet to trust in Jesus.
Yes.
See, I have proved Him over and over again, and in every situation and every trial, He has proven Himself faithful. And this song says, I'm not afraid to trust Him. I depend on Him. Right now the sea is troubled, and the night has been so long. For the dawn.
has been so long. Out on the open water, I prayed for the dawn.
Y'all.
until I found you, and I'd do it all again.
Calvary, there is a peace.
touch Calvary. There is a peace.
This morning.
Amen.
I want to share just a little testimony with you, or maybe a sermon, and if that's all right, preacher. Just,
amen.
He said to mind the Lord, and that's why we're here this morning. It's not about us, it's about Him.
Amen.
We got snowed out this week. We were supposed to be in Pikeville, Kentucky meeting, but they got 2 foot of snow, and it was bad up in the mountains. And so we've been home all week, which is highly unusual for us. But in that week, I got to do some studying and working some new sermons up, because these two said that, you know, you need to get some new sermons. They can preach the ones I've got, they think. But I told them it takes a little different thing about preaching.
Amen.
And that takes the unction of the Holy Spirit. But I was reading, and I know you're familiar with this story, but God just spoke to my heart this week. I was reading about the two disciples on the road to Emmaus. How many is familiar,
amen,
with that? And the Bible said as they walked and talked along, that Jesus appeared and began to walk with them. And He talked with them. And they went a journey, and He asked them, why are you so sorrowful? You know, and they say, are you a stranger here? And do you not know that they crucified Jesus, the one who we thought would set up the kingdom and who would be our Messiah? And can you imagine how He felt in listening to them talk about this? And then it said, they bid Him to come and stop and have a meal. And the Bible says this, that He took the bread and He blessed it, and then He broke it. And then the next line says, and their eyes were opened. And God spoke to my heart. We travel all over the eastern United States and I do a lot of revivals and stuff, and we're evangelists. We go to bless the people through God to bless us, and then to win the lost. And here's what God spoke to me. What do I have to break before you open your eyes and realize who I am? What does He have to break? Sometimes He has to break our will. Sometimes our well, you probably all don't have to worry about this, but sometimes our pride, He has to break our pride. And to the lost, I thought the bread meant life. He said, I am the bread of life. And blessings, He gives us all the blessings. All blessings we have comes down from the Father in heaven. And whether you've accepted Christ or whether you've not accepted Christ, if you're lost this morning, you still be.